Anand in Gujarat, known for the white revolution and cooperative sectors. The milk capital of India is also one of the most prosperous districts of Gujarat.
As India decides, we are here at Amul headquarters in Anand. The election carnival has reached here. So we decided to get you a taste of India, and what better place to understand the mood of India than Amul with the women who have scripted the Amul story.
Dhwani Shah works in the quality control department of Amul. It's been 18 years since her journey in Amul began, and she speaks about how the institution has kept pace with technology and has also gone completely paperless in the last few years.
It's a fantastic journey from when I started in 2004 till 2024. It is a very fabulous journey, and I have seen many changes in Amul and equally in my life also.
Tell me, your life and Amul's journey. Tell us the points where they meet.
I'm taking a pride because I'm working with the cooperative, which is the world largest cooperative. So it is being a pride for me and my family too. Because when we move na, we move around na. Sab, if we wear this uniform na, people ask us, you are from Amul. So it is very proud moment for us.
Amul continues to be an equally utterly butterly story for 25-year-old Rinkle Pipalia, who after completing her master's in microbiology got a job here 7 months ago.
This is a fascinating uniform. All the employees are expected to wear this?
Yes.
And so the moment you enter, you're supposed to wear this blue kurta with a
pant, black pant.
Beautiful Amul written on it.
Yes. yes. It is my career starting point, and I am feeling so much proud to wear this uniform.
Thank you so much.
Anand has carved a unique place on the world map for its Amul milk products and cooperative movements, and continues to be a story still unfolding.
Have you seen the latest logo or caption of Amul India? It says Roti Kapda or Matdan, because we are in the election season, and let's try and get details of the India story from the man who is running Amul in India, the MD of Amul, and he has decided to give us time in Anand and at the headquarters of Amul. Sir, the first message and your thought, particularly in an election season.
Well, this is a good time to talk about India, where India is going to head for the next 5, 10, 20, 25 years. And this is where each of us takes a call on what we are going to do to make India bigger and better. So the first message is, to each one of us, we should all vote with the families to see that we are a part of the great democratic process that India has.
And Mr. Mehta, we are standing at the Dr. V. Kurian Memorial, and also this is the Dairy Museum.
Yes.
So the legacy, is there a burden of legacy, or would you say that it gives you inspiration to ensure that this is a brand which remains the trusted and also the strongest food brand of India?
Yeah, absolutely right. I mean, it's actually not the burden, it's the power of the legacy and the strength of the cooperative movement that Amul has become what it is today. You can imagine, we started 77 years back, this very place, and from just two village cooperative societies and 250 liters of milk, today Amul is in 18,600 villages of Gujarat. 36 lakh farmer families are members of this cooperative movement. We're getting 310 lakh liters of milk every day, which is
310
lakh liters of milk every day. And there are 100 dairy plants like Amul Anand across the country, which is processing this milk. And the brand turnover is 80,000 crore rupees. So a $10 billion brand, which has been created on the sheer power of the 36 lakh farmers coming to form a cooperative. So this is what is the India story. This is what is the story of women empowerment. This is the story of development. And the word you rightly mentioned, that the Amul's currency is not milk, it is trust. Yes. And this trust of a billion consumers, trust of millions of farmers, that's what keeps us going day in and day out.
And with every passing year, that trust is only strengthening. That trust is not going anywhere. Right now in India, we also have the cooperative minister.
Yes.
You know, Mr. Yes. Amit Shah is also yes. the cooperative yes. minister. What is the role of cooperatives in the India story in general?
So I think this is the great time for cooperatives because you got strong tailwinds for the sector. The power of this Amul model has been realized and everyone in the government and the Ministry of Cooperation is the pivot and the fulcrum on which the new initiatives which support cooperatives across the country are happening. Amul, of course, is a player in all of these activities. I'll talk about the three new multi-state cooperatives which have been recently formed. The National Cooperative Exports Limited, National Cooperative Organics Limited and the Bharatiya Beej Sahakari Limited. Hmm. So what you are trying to say is Amul is successful today because we got access to the market of Bombay and the farmers went on a strike in 1946. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel inspired them and this led to Amul what it is today. So imagine now through the efforts of this new Ministry of Cooperation, you are now giving an access to the market of all the products produced by every single cooperative in India through the multi-state cooperative on exports, which Amul is one of the promoters, the chief promoter in fact. So we are incubating a startup which did a turnover of 1400 crores last year, order book of 15,000 crores, $2 billion, yes, and nobody knows about it. But this is what is the thought process of giving market access to the produce of the farmers globally. Similarly, farmers wanting to get into organics, consumer wanting to get into organic food without chemical fertilizer and pesticides, and this new multi-state doing this job, Amul also on its own doing this job. So many initiatives happening in place. India, like Amul, I talked about 18,600 villages. India has got 7 lakh villages. There are Amul type cooperative in 2 lakh villages. So the ministry has given us a task that of the balance 5 lakh villages, you open dairy cooperatives in 2 lakh villages in the next 5 to 10 years. So what happened in 50 years will now going to happen in next 5 years. So more milk will come in the cooperative sector, more women will get benefit of this particular initiative. And India, which is currently contributing to 24% of the total milk in the world, in next 10 years will contribute to 1/3 of the total milk in the world. So we have this great chance to become a dairy to the world.
Hmm.
And milk today also is the largest agricultural crop of India. So India produces 230 million metric ton of milk, which is equivalent to 63 crore liters a day. At 10 lakh crore rupees, the value of output of milk is more than wheat, paddy, oil seeds put together. So this is the power of how a small thing which started in Anand in 1946, inspired by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, in whose memory the name Hall's name has been kept, to Dr. Kurian and the team working day in and day out, has resulted to India getting this preeminent position and cooperatives now getting a center space into all the development initiatives across all the villages of the country is amazing achievement.
Mr. Mehta, you know, one thought that comes to my mind often is that would we have seen this Amul story had it been in any other state of India? Do you think it worked because it started in Gujarat?
Gujarat, of course, we were blessed by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Morarji Desai, the initial leaders, and Tribhuvanas Patel, who was the founder chairman of Amul Dairy here, to have worked hard to create what it is. But then the same model got replicated across India. So you have Saras in Rajasthan, which is doing so well. You have Nandini in Karnataka, which is doing well. Avin in Tamil Nadu, Milma in Kerala, Sudha in Bihar. So every single state has a dairy cooperative. And all of them, be it Varka in Punjab to the mother dairy in Delhi, each one of them are doing a great job in connecting their producers with the consumers and doing a lot of work. So together, actually, we have been able to dominate this space. And as India and farmers of India, it's a place of pride which cooperatives hold in our country.
Now, right now, India is being seen as this bright spot and almost like a sweet spot in the world economy.
Yeah.
What do you think India's growth story is likely to be in the coming few years? Your own vision vis-a-vis Amul.
So I told about dairy. And India, if it becomes a dairy to the world, Amul has to be leading this. But we are not talking of just selling milk and milk products to the consumers around the world. Amul has a relevance of exporting this model also. So a farmer cooperative model will can also make several countries in the developing world become self-sufficient in dairy and milk, which is a very important nutritional requirement. And more importantly, providing livelihood to their local people. So we are talking with the government of Sri Lanka and helping them become Atmanirbhar. We are talking to Kenya and also supporting them or working with them to build the dairy industry in there. So there are several developing...
Sri Lanka and Kenya. Which are other countries?
So there are, this is a model for development which can work in every country of the global south. And that's where the Honorable Prime Minister talked about the South-South initiative in his G20 leadership.
Yes.
It is now being put in place.
That's Global South because you've spoken about it. Let's talk about it now. Particularly the role of milk revolutions and what role can India play in revolutionizing the entire, Global South, according to you.
So this is where it is. So it's the products which go to the markets, we take the products and there's opportunity and the model goes to all the developing countries, and where you need product like milk, which is giving not only nutrition to consumers but livelihood to the farmers. So this is what is a superb combination which is going to happen. And you won't believe, a few months back we had all the executive directors of World Bank coming to Anand. They saw this model, 16 of them who represent more than 100 countries, and then they realized that if India has to give a gift of development to the world, Amul is the model which it can give. So this is where we are working on. There are several countries we are talking to, and not just talking, putting things in place, in action, on the ground, with the required investments, without expecting a return in form of the money which comes out back, but more important, the results on the ground in that country.
And we have seen, there's a lot of emphasis on women, because I spoke to women of Amul just some time back.
Yes.
And I also met Gayatri Ben, who... in many ways is the face of the cooperative in this entire region, sir. Women, the role of women in brand Amul.
No, of course, they are doing the fundamental work. So, the girl is, of course, the icon and identity. But coming back to
Will this girl ever grow up?
No, she has to be kept young as the country is young. But more importantly, it's the women who do the hard work. There are 3.6 million women who own this brand. And Amul is the world's largest farmer-owned cooperative, obviously powered by the women and empowering them. So you can imagine more than 18 lakh bank accounts of women, and out of the 200 crore rupees which every day Amul gives back to the farmers in their bank accounts, more than half go to the women bank account. There are 80,000 women who run the village dairy cooperative societies. There are more than one third of the village cooperative societies which are fully run, operated and managed by women. So this is indeed a very, very great example. And it's interesting because Amul was made the institutional partner of W20 as a part of the G20 also, because this is what, it's not of development of women. Prime Minister sir told it's women-led development, and that's what this is model we wanted to showcase and highlight. So yes, obviously it's without women, nothing would have been possible.
Traditionally a stronghold of the Congress, which won here 10 times, the constituency was won by the BJP for the first time in 1989. Since Mr. Modi became Prime Minister of India in 2014, Anand, like all 26 Lok Sabha constituencies of Gujarat, have only voted for the BJP.
अरे आप देख सकते हो, जैसे पढ़े लिखे आदमी जो है उनको तो पता ही है कि अपनी जो गवर्नमेंट है तो डेयरी और एग्रीकल्चर को बढ़ावा देने के लिए क्या कुछ नहीं करती है, और पढ़े लिखे नहीं भी है उनको भी आप पूछोगे तो अभी वो उनकी एक इमेज बन गई है कि इलेक्शन मतलब बीजेपी.
अच्छा, लेकिन ये गुजरात है शायद इसलिए.
नहीं, ऐसी बात नहीं है. मोदी जी का काम तो सबको दिखता है. मोदी जी का काम सबको दिखता है और हमें भी समझ है कि डेयरी फार्म और एग्रीकल्चर को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए क्या क्या सहायता होती है. जैसे गवर्नमेंट की जो सब्सिडीज वगैरह सब स्कीम्स आती है, लोगों तक पहले पहुंच नहीं पाती थी. अब मोदी जी ने वो एक सरल बना दिया है कि एकदम निचले कक्ष का जो आदमी भी होगा, मतलब ज़्यादा पढ़ा लिखा भी नहीं होगा, तो उसको भी ये स्कीम के बारे में कैसे पता करे, अवेयर कैसे करे, ये बात के लिए मोदी जी सोचते हैं.
गायत्री पटेल रन्स वंश डेयरी इन अजारपुरा इन आनंद. दिस 44 ईयर ओल्ड हैज बीन यूजिंग काउ डंग फॉर मल्टीपल प्रोडक्ट्स.
डेयरी फार्म की वजह से आज मैं पहचानी जाती हूँ, गायत्री पटेल गोबर वाली.
गोबर वाली।
हाँ, क्योंकि मैं वैल्यू एडिशन करती हूँ। देखिए, पशुपालन के ऊपर आपको जब सरवाइव करना है तो अकेले दूध के ऊपर तो आप निर्भर कर ही नहीं सकते हो, क्योंकि उसमें 2 महीना जब गाय ड्राइंग में जाती है उस टाइम पे भी उसको अच्छा वाला फीड की जरूरत पड़ती है। उस टाइम पे क्या होता है, जब गाय जो दूध देती है उसके ऊपर बर्डन पड़ती है। तो हम कोविड के टाइम पे जब बाहर कहीं जाना नहीं होता था तो उस टाइम पे सोचा कि भैया उसका कुछ वैल्यू एडिशन किया जाए, कि जैसे हम लोग आत्मनिर्भर बनने के लिए डेयरी फार्म बनाए हैं तो गाय खुद ही आत्मनिर्भर बन जाए। जब वो दूध नहीं देती है तो वो गोबर देती है, तो गोबर का कुछ ऐसे वैल्यू एडिशन किया जाए कि जैसे नॉर्मल गोबर से आपको जितना मुनाफा मिलता है, जितना पैसा मिलता है, उससे थोड़ा कम थोड़ा ज्यादा पैसा मिल जाएगा तो खुद का खाने का खर्चा खुद ही उठाएगी। तो ऐसा सोच के हमने पहले ये गोबर वाले गमले बनाना शुरू किया। अब भी आप देखेंगे उधर स्टोर में मैंने आउटलेट जैसा बनाया है, तो करीब करीब 30 या 35 आइटम्स जो है जो हम गोबर से वैल्यू एडिशन करके बनाते हैं।
Chairman of the Dairy Cooperative Society, Gayatri, a BCom graduate, started in 2016 with just 5 calves. Today, her dairy farm has 80 animals.
आप देख सकते हो अंदर गीर गाय भी है साथ में।
कौन सी दिखाई?
ये जो लाल वाली गाय है वो गीर गाय है।
अच्छा।
और गीर गाय का जबकि मिल्क प्रोडक्शन कम होता है तो लोग इसीलिए ज्यादा उनको रखने की नहीं सोचते हैं। लेकिन हमने क्या किया, भले ही उसका दूध कम है लेकिन A2 मिल्क है, कंपेयर टू क्रॉस ब्रीड उसके दूध में जो है गुणवत्ता है, क्वालिटी है। तो इसकी वजह से हमें उसका तो दूध का तो ज्यादा पैसा मिलेगा। और साथ ही साथ में पंचगव्य के ऊपर हम जब काम करेंगे, जैसे
पंचगव्य क्या होता है,
पंचगव्य माने गोबर, गौमूत्र, दूध, घी और दही, 5 में से कोई भी एक चीज मिला के जब आप कोई उत्पाद बनाते हो तो वो पंचगव्य उत्पाद बोले जाते हैं। जिससे हम हेयर ऑयल बना सकते हैं, मालिश तेल बना सकते हैं, मेथी कॉफी बना सकते हैं, दंत मंजन बना सकते हैं, फेस पैक बना सकते हैं, बर्तन घिसने वाला पाउडर बना सकते हैं, गौमूत्र अर्क बना सकते हैं, बहुत सारी चीजें जो है, अगरबत्ती बना सकते हैं, फिर दुबत्ती बना सकते हैं, बहुत सारी चीजें जो है वो देसी गाय के पंचगव्य से बना सकते हैं। तो ऐसे ये पंचगव्य का वैल्यू एडिशन कर करके उसका सर्वाइवल रेट को बढ़ा सकते हैं। तो ये सब चीजों को आप जब ध्यान से सोचोगे, सुनोगे, उसके बारे में थोड़ा बहुत विचार करोगे तो आप कभी भी देसी गाय को छोड़ोगे नहीं। और देसी गाय जो है तो प्राकृतिक कृषि आपने सुना होगा, नेचुरल फार्मिंग जो करते हैं, तो उसमें फर्टिलाइजर का यूज नहीं होता है, सिर्फ गाय आधारित ही खेती होती है। तो वो तो माने जाए कि अमृत ही है। तो अभी हम लिटरली जहर खा रहे हैं कि फर्टिलाइजर का यूज गवर्नमेंट भी बोलती है। और अपने आचार्य देवव्रत सर जी बोलते हैं कि गवर्नमेंट जो बोलते हैं कि आप ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग या नेचुरल फार्मिंग करो, नेचुरल फार्मिंग से जो भी आप बनाया हुआ खाओगे तो आपका आयुष्य 5 या 10 साल बढ़ने वाला है।
Let's try and get you a sense of what the first-time voters are thinking. And interestingly, a group of second-year engineering students from Pandit Deen Dayal Energy University in Gandhinagar are here on a campus visit of Amul in Anand. So let's try and get a sense of what their thoughts are. Kis issue pe vote hoga?
I would say about job market. That will be a big issue because we are graduating after 2 years. And for employment, we also need job. And yeah, that's the biggest reason from my side.
Your biggest concern is jobs. What about you?
I will vote on the based of the work done by previous government. And I think it has satisfied our the demands. So I will vote on basis of the previous government.
Okay, so since this is the vote for Prime Minister Modi, because he is himself on the ticket here, and from Gandhinagar, the university from where you're coming, it is Home Minister Amit Shah who is contesting.
We will definitely vote for him. He has done many works. The roads here are superior. And so we will keep that in mind. And he has also done many works, like he has rebuilt Ram Mandir, then 370, Section 370 has removed. So we will keep all that in mind and vote on basis of that.
So Ram Temple and Article 370, are these issues for you?
Actually, the main issue for the students are the job employment market. And the poverty is also main concern because the salary demand is also high rising because of inflation in the market. So that's the main concern for our students. And we would see how the promises are made in the moment of the government and other parties that have promised for this 2024 election. and we will vote according to that.
Okay, so as a young female voter, what are the issues on your mind?
For me, one of the most is safety, and the other one is the current, what are the promises they are making and what benefits will be getting from the student perspective, because there are many things that they provide and the promises, but major is that for students, what is beneficial and for not.
Yes, absolutely. So tell us in terms of how important is it for all of you, first-time voters, that you'll be looking at the local candidate and not the person who is going to govern India, that is Prime Minister Modi. Local candidate versus national face.
The local candidate, we want to vote for local candidate, not our Prime Minister or meet faces, because we are looking local candidates works in our areas. And
so, aapke liye local candidate issue hai. What about you?
For me, it is Narendra Modi, because he has passed 10 years of experience. He has done many good work in this field, demonetization, then all Article 370, increase in employment rates and etc.
Okay, why do you say Article 370?
Because Kashmir is ours, and he provoked that law.
Yeah. So he removed that, he removed Article 370. But talking specifically about this emotive issue, have you visited Kashmir yet?
No, I have not yet.
But you plan?
But I plan to visit.
You plan to visit. Okay. So tell me, what about all of you? What are the issues for you this election?
Nothing more issues. The government has done a very good job for the development of the country, giving more and more development for next 10 to 12 years they have given. So
there is a great degree of satisfaction.
Yeah.
Okay. You're satisfied as well?
I'm satisfied.
You're a first-time voter?
Yeah, I'm a first-time voter. So, but the main issue is unemployment in India. Like, it is gradually rising. That's why.
So you're concerned about it?
Yeah.
But the BJP government says that they have made all of you, the youth of India, as employment generators. Aap log naukriyan de rahe hain rather than naukri dhoondne ja rahe
hain. Naukri de to rahe, but lekin mostly kya ho raha hai ki in India, like jitne bhi job sectors wale hain, wo log unemployment bahut zyada ho raha hai un logon ke liye. And jin logon ko jobs hai, unko mil bhi nahi raha jobs.
So wo concern hai.
Wo concern.
Aapke liye kya concern hai?
Same unemployment, because with the rise of technology and artificial intelligence, automation, so the jobs are declining. In the industry, Amul industry right now, we also saw that after the automation in 1996, the decrease in employment was there. So that's what I mean.
The number of people who were being employed went down. Thank you so much for speaking to NDTV.
All 26 seats of Gujarat poll in a single phase on 7th of May. In Anand, this is Maria Shakir.